கிளம்ப பண்ணுங்க.
Good evening to you all. I request all of you to join us for the lighting of the traditional lamp by the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Thiru Banwarilal Purohit ji. That will be the formal inauguration of the evening. Request all of you to join us for the Tamil Thaivaazhthu. That will be followed by Vande Mataram. It will be led by Vidushi Aruna Sairam ji, and we request all the children to sing along for this invocation.
நீராறும் கடலுடுத்த நிலமடந்தை எழுந்தொழுகும் சீராறும் வதனமென திகழ்வரத கண்டமிது தேக்கணமும் அதில் சிறந்த திராவிடனல் திருநாடும் தக்க சிறு பிறை நுதலும் தரித்தனரும் திலகமுமே அத்திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுற எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழனங்கே தமிழனங்கே உன் சீரிலமை திறம் வியந்து செயல் மறந்து வாழ்த்ததுமே வந்தே மாதரம் வந்தே மாதரம் வந்தே மாதரம் வந்தே மாதரம் சுஜராம் சுபராம் மலயஜசீதலாம் சஷ்யஷாமலாம் மாதரம் வந்தே மாதரம் சுப்ரஜோத்ஸ்னா புலகிதயாலினி புல்ல കുസുമിത ധ്രുമല ശോഭിനി സുവാസിനി സുമധുരഭാഷിനി സുഫലാമരദാം മാതരം വന്ദേ മാതരം വന്ദേ മാതരം
Thank you all. We'll now have the welcome address by Sri M. Krishnamurthy, Honorary Secretary, Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha.
Ellarukkum namaskaram. Good evening to all. தமிழ் தாய் வாழ்த்து ஒரு ரொம்ப இது இது மாதிரி இந்த அளவுக்கு தமிழ் தாய் வாழ்த்தையும் வந்தே மாத்திரம் நம்ம பாடி எங்குமே பார்த்ததில்லை. இந்த சில்ட்ரன்ஸ் ஹான்ரபிள் கவர்னர் வந்திருக்கார், அவங்க முன்னிலையில் ரொம்ப அருமையாக பாடினாங்க. அது வந்து மனசை ஒரு பெரிய தொடர நிகழ்ச்சியாக இருந்தது. அவங்களுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் நான் வருக வருக என்று வரவேற்கின்றேன். இட் இஸ் மை ப்ளெஷர் அண்ட் ப்ரிவிலேஜ் டு வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் கர்நாடிகா அண்ட் ஸ்ரீ பார்த்தசாரதி சுவாமி சபா to the 13th edition of Lancor Bharat Sangeet Utsav. We are much honored and happy that Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Thiru Banwarilal Purohit, is gracing the occasion as chief guest and kindly accepting to inaugurate the festival. Two great institutions, Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, a 116 years old organization dedicated to the cause of Indian culture and arts, and Carnatica, an institution that is pioneering the development of arts and culture, exploring the techniques, the latest technology effectively, have joined hands together to host Bharat Sangeet Utsav, a celebration of pan-Indian music. Over the past many years, this festival has provided a platform to showcase some unique forms of our music and celebrate it for a social cause and welfare each year. In continuation, this year it is an aid of Vidya Sagar, formerly known as Spastic Society of India. And today the inaugural program will be a concert, a musical salutation to Mother India by Srimati Aruna Sairam, with 300 children trained and curated by Dr. Sudha Raja. Likewise, last year it was for the cast of blind children, and the inaugural concert was Women's Musical Luminaries of India. This is the uniqueness of Bharat Sangeet Utsav. On this special occasion, we, and on behalf of Rasikas, we cordially welcome our Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Thiru Banwarilal Purohit. Assumed office recently. Saban Pakarcha, Association Pakarcha, ஹானரபிள் கவர்னர், இதுதான் ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஃபங்க்ஷன் நாங்கள் நினைக்கிறோம். அது நம்மளுக்கெல்லாம் ஒரு பெரிய பெருமை. ப்ரீவியஸ்லி வாஸ் தி கவர்னர் ஆஃப் அசாம் ஸ்டேட். அவர் ஹானரபிள் கவர்னர் இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி வெட்டரன் லீடர்ஸ் ஆஃப் அவர் கிரேட் கண்ட்ரி, த்ரைஸ் மெம்பர் ஆஃப் பார்லிமெண்ட். வி ஆர் வெரி ஹாப்பி அண்ட் ப்ரவுட் தட் ஈ ஹாஸ் கிரேட் நாலேஜ் அண்ட் கொனேஷியர் ஆஃப் அவர் ஃபைன் ஆர்ட்ஸ். ஈ இஸ் க்ளோஸ்லி கனெக்டட் வித் பாரதிய வித்யா பவன், அண்ட் ஈ அண்ட் இஸ் ஃபேமிலி ஆர் சஸ்டெயின்ட் ஆக்டிவ் டோனர்ஸ் for our Indian art and culture. We once again welcome him and respect with pranams. We welcome Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chettiar sir. He is the president and of most of our sabhas and cultural organizations and a philanthropist. He is a liberal donor for arts, culture and education, author of many books, a man of impeccable honesty. He is one of the key persons in making Chennai a capital of fine arts and music festivals. We welcome renowned classical vocalist Vidushi Aruna Sairam, who is also the Vice President of Sangeet Natak Academy, New Delhi. She has taken our Carnatic music to the global arena. One of the main contributor for spreading and making Carnatic music more popular worldwide, founder of Nada Yogam Trust, which works for music education for underprivileged children. She always supports Bharat Sangeet Utsav with her good, fantastic concerts. We congratulate Vidwan Shashikiran for scheduling a wonderful lineup of this festival. And every festival, and responsible for taking this festival to the 13th year. He has a remarkable enthusiasm, vision, and ideas. Eminent Carnatic musician and familiar guru has number of students worldwide. We also welcome Sri Mohan Parasaran, one of our vice presidents and the one of the trustees of Carnatica, who made it possible from Delhi. In fact, he just flown from Delhi in the morning, attended his court work, and directly he has come here. We welcome him on behalf of both the institutions. We are happy to welcome Srimati Mallika Ravi, Group CEO, Lancor Holdings Limited. An event of this scale, year after year, will not be possible without the support of Lancor. Srimati Mallika Ravi is responsible for spearheading the company for its growth. An ardent lover of Carnatic music, she and Lancor are always a part of us and guiding us for the success of all our endeavors. We welcome the individuals helping us. Huge welcome to all the executives of our sponsors, Lancor, Nalli, ACT, DCB Bank, Scania, Giri Trading, Co-optex, Ananta, SVS College of Engineering, Kamadenu, and the residency. We also welcome and thank Sri Murali for his support for the festival. We also welcome the entire staff members of our Honorable Governor's Office and Raj Bhavan. We also welcome all the artists participating in the festival, and particularly the performing artists of today. Our friends in the digital and print media have always been our pillar of strength and support to us all these years. We are pleased to welcome them. Most importantly, we welcome the Rasikas who attend our programs in large numbers and making the festival wonderful year after year. We also welcome Sri Harishankar and Sri Ravichandran of Naradagan Sabha for providing this hall with fullest cooperation. We welcome everyone making the festival possible, committee members of Sri Parsai Sam Sabha and the team Karnataka. We request you to come every day and add glory to this festival by your presence. Namaste.
We would now like to honor our Honorable Chief Guest, Honorable Governor, Thiru Banwarilal Purohit. I request Sri Nalli Kuppuswami Chettiyar, sir, to honor him.
Om Tvamagne Rudra Asura Maha Divaha Tadum Jadho Marutam Praksha Ishishe Tvam Vatair Arunair Yasi Shangajaha Tvam Bhusha Vidhatas Pasi Nutpana Deva Deve Shushrajadvam Prathabad Vitije Shushrajadvam Dvitijas Tritije Shushrajadvam Tritijas Chaturthe Shushrajadvam Chaturthah Panchame Shushrajadvam Panchamah Shashthe Shushrajadvam Shashthah Saptame Shushrajadvam Saptamah Ashtame Shushrajadvam.
I request our Chief Guest, Honorable Governor, to now honor the other dignitaries with a shawl and a memento. Dr. Sudha Raja, who was instrumental in coordinating all the children and their singing, will be honored by the Governor. I shall now request Thirumathi Aruna Sairam, Vice President, Sangeet Natak Academy, and a leading Carnatic musician, to give her special address.
Ellorukkum namaskaram. Namaskar to all the dignitaries on the stage. We in India are truly a blessed and a very, very specially gifted country, because the greatest pride that we have is our culture, our spirituality, and the divine pursuits that are followed in our country. So, namaskaram to all the ancestors who have given us this great tradition. And this function is happening in the presence of such a wonderful individual as His Excellency the Governor, who all his life, his entire working life, has been spent only in supporting, uplifting, preserving, and propagating the culture of our country. What could be more appropriate than his presence today for this wonderful event conceived and presented by Bharat Sangeet Utsav, yet another pioneer and a leader in this wonderfully cultural city of Chennai, Bharat Sangeet Utsav. Congratulations and namaskarams to you for the wonderful work that you do. Sashi Kiran is truly an indomitable spirit. National integration is something that binds us, it unites us. And musical national integration, musically expressing oneself, it's a communication beyond words, and that immediately touches the heart of people and binds us all into one India. Today we are going to sing patriotic songs in different languages of the country, and we offer this as a offering at the feet of Bharat Mata in the presence of all these wonderful dignitaries seated here today. Community, society, all of us coming together and singing together is a very purifying experience. I think I'm so lucky that I'm going to sing with 300 children today. What could be more blessed? Also present on the stage is respected Nalli Chettiar Avargal, who has changed the map of the city. I keep saying this every time, and I will not tire of saying this, because I am one of those artists who has seen the before and the after. When I was a struggling artist, I used to come here from Bombay, and I know what it was then, the scene. There was hardly any sponsorship, any support. The artist has to come on your own steam. You have to do your own thing. You have to get back on your own. You are almost like an unsung hero or a heroine in this wilderness. And after the advent of Nalli Chettiar, all of that changed. He just made us feel wanted. He made us feel supported. He made us feel happy to do culture and music. Mohan Parasaran ji is yet another towering figure in the same arena. He is such a busy person professionally. He is one of the leading lights in the legal profession of this country, and yet he finds time to support the arts and culture. I salute him. And Parthasarathy Swami, Sabha, and Krishnamurti ji are synonymous with each other. This Sabha was started in the year 1900. 1900, can you believe it? So many years. And he is now holding the reins of this Sabha. So we are all so happy to be here. And last but not least, we saw the beautiful symbols and signs and the singing of the students of the Vidya Sagar school. They sang with us. When we sang with our voices, they sang with the whole body. You must have seen that. It was so beautiful. We look forward to a couple of more pieces with the Vidya Sagar students, and the entire proceeds of this function will be offered to the Vidya Sagar students' benefit. All in all, once again, congratulations, Bharat Sangeet Utsav, for such a grand function. Namaskaram.
That was a wonderful special address by Tirumati Aruna Sairamji. We'll now have a presidential address by Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chetty, the president of Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, and I request the governor to honor him with a shawl. And also Sri Mohan Parasaran. Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chetty.
Good evening, friends. Today, we have the honor and pleasure to receive in our midst our Governor, His Excellency, Sri Banwarilal Purohit. Your Excellency, we welcome you heartily. I think this is the city's first ever cultural event that His Excellency participates. From my brief meetings with His Excellency at the Raj Bhavan, I came to know that he is very much interested in traditional arts and culture. Fittingly, we receive him at an event jointly sponsored by the oldest Sabha and one of the youngest Sabhas of the city. Sri Parthasarathy Sabha is the oldest of the cultural societies in the whole of Southeast Asia. It is heading for its fourth centenary silver jubilee year. Karnataka is the one of the youngest sabhas, catering to the tastes and trends of modern times even while fostering the tradition. His Excellency has been the editor of Central India's oldest English daily, the Hitwada. That apart, he is an eminent educationist also. He is vice president and trustee of All India Bharati Vidya Bhavan and Chairman Nagpur Kendra. That's why we consider His Excellency presence here as a matter of honor and prestige. He was responsible for making the South Central Cultural Zone vibrant. Sir, we deem it a singular honor to be blessed by you with your presence. We eagerly await your benedictory address. At this grand function, it is our pleasure to offer felicitations to the renowned Vidushi Srimati Aruna Sairam, who takes by storm her audience wherever she performs. For long, she has been living in Mumbai. When she came to settle in Chennai, the city did not want to leave her. She is now part of cultural life in Chennai, though she commands audience across the globe. Her abhangs are inimitable. Possible that His Excellency had occasion to listen to her. She is now vice chairperson of the Central Sangeet Natak Academy, New Delhi. If you want a houseful event, host Aruna Sairam is the byword in the world of Carnatic music. That's why we honor her with His Excellency's presence. It will be cherished by her and her countless connoisseurs. As this meeting is time bound, I have to be brief, not to take over your time. I extend my warm welcome to His Excellency once again and thank all the office bearers of the two sabhas of their cooperation in arranging the event. Thank you once again. Thank one and all.
would also like to sincerely thank Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chetty for having spontaneously contributed a sum of rupees 1 lakh for this event. Our sincere thanks. He was moved and he has done that spontaneously. We'll now have the pleasure of inviting our chief guest, Honorable Governor Thiru Banwarilal Purohit ji. His presence is indeed something to be treasured. He has been very actively involved in music, culture, and his coming to Chennai is a blessing for all the organizations, and we are so honored and privileged and blessed to have him, and we would have the pleasure of hearing his chief guest address now.
Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chetty, President Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, Tirumati Aruna Sairam, Vice President, Sangeet Natak Academy, New Delhi, Sri Mohan Parasaran, former Solicitor General of India, Thiru M. Krishnamurti, Honorary Secretary, Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, Dr. K. N. Sasikiran, Managing Trustee, Carnatica, distinguished invitees, musician, performing artists, office bearers, and members of Karnataka and Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, students, Rashikas, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to inaugurate the Bharat Sangeet Utsav 2017, a pan-Indian music festival organized by Karnataka in association with Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, showcasing the richness of the different musical forms present in India. Music is divine. It is universal. The roots of classic music of India are found in the Vedic literature. Ours is a land of art and beauty. It is a land of yogis, great and devoted artists, Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is himself a cosmic dancer. And Goddess Saraswati is the goddess of music and knowledge. The ancient Sanskrit text, Natya Shastra, identifies and discusses 22 Shrutis and seven Swaras. The Swara studies in the ancient Sanskrit text state the categories of melodic models, the raga composition, etc. Music is the complete expression of the soul of India, reflecting its inner life. It is the essence of civilization. Hindustani and Carnatic music are a class by themselves. Dr. Rukmini Devi Arundule said, I quote, "For me, music is beyond sound and words. Just as the voice or an instrument is the vehicle of music, so is a musician. So as the musician, the vehicle through whom this divine influence powers, the great artists and masters of the past did not have all the modern facilities like audio-visual instruments. The recording theaters that are available today, the trinity of Carnatic music, Thyagaraja, Muthuswami, Dikshitar and Shyam Shastri are known for shaping and influencing Carnatic music in unparalleled way. They are still remembered and respected by all because of their pursuit of this divine art. The discipline, devotion and dedication shown by the great musicians of yesteryear should be imbibed in the young budding artists, and they should draw inspiration from them. I congratulate Karnataka and Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha for encouraging the young and energetic artists by featuring their performance in junior slots prior to main events every day. I am sure this will not only provide them an opportunity to showcase their talent, but will also help to identify, motivate, nurture and explore the talents in the young budding artists. The initiative taken by Karnataka to conduct Pan India Music Festival encompassing Indian classical music, Carnatic and Hindustani, as well as our pristine dance forms globally, is laudable. It is heartening to witness the inaugural concert featured by Tirumati Aruna Sairam, Vande Matram, a music salutation to Mother India, under your leadership, performed by more than 200 children and about 50 special care children. I tell you, it is really amazing. It is really amazing. I congratulate Tirumati Aruna Sairam and Dr. Sudha Raja and all the participating students for their wonderful performance. The Vande Matram rendered by them has left this hall, including myself, with vibration rekindling in us the patriotic fervor and our devotion to Bharat Mata. I am happy to learn that this Utsav also features fusion concerts, sing-along concert by Sudha Raghunathan, and there are music concerts by other leading artists. More and more young children should be motivated to learn Carnatic and Hindustani music. Dances like Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, folk arts, painting, etc. The richness of our art form should be passed on to our younger generation without losing its pristine form. Simplicity and divinity is the essence of the art. Every home should become a center for art and culture. Let us revive this spirit to make our rich art and culture known to the whole world, known to the universe. I congratulate Karnataka Archival Center for its innovative ways to promote and propagate Indian music. I am pleased to learn that this year Bharat Sangeet Utsav is dedicated to raising awareness about the challenges faced by intellectually challenged individuals. Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha is one of the oldest cultural institutions in Tamil Nadu, which is associated with Bharat Sangeet Utsav 2017. I commend the services rendered by Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha for hosting the performance of musicians all over India and for serving the cause of promotion of our art and culture. Ved Vidya Sagar, a non-profit organization, deserves commendation for delivering quality services to intellectually challenged and differently able children, focusing on early intervention, special education, physiotherapy, speech and communication therapy, etc., and for training of resource persons to work in the field of disability. I am sure renowned musicians from all over India will make the Bharat Sangeet Utsav 2017, which is a prelude to the Chennai December Music Festival, a special and memorable one. Chennai is the hub of Carnatic music. I am confident that such festivals will strengthen our national integration, promote our art and culture. I convey my warm felicitation to Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chetty, President, Office Bearers and Members of Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, Dr. K.N. Sasikiran, Managing Trustee, Office Bearers and Members of Karnataka, to all the performing artists, young talented emerging artists, members of Vidyasagar student, Rasikas, and all those who are associated with Bharat Sangeet Utsav. I wish Bharat Sangeet Utsav 2017 all success. My greeting to you all. Jai Hind, Jai Tamil Nadu, Vadakkam.
We thank our chief guest, Thiru Banwarilal Purohit, the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu. It was such a moving and erudite speech. We are blessed and honored to have you, sir. We shall now have the vote of thanks by Sri Mohan Parasaran, Chairman of Karnataka and Vice President of Sri Parthasarathy Swami Sabha.
Distinguished and esteemed Excellency Purohitji, Negaratra Kodaivallal, Sri Nalli Kuppuswami Avargal, Doyen of Carnatic music, who actually is holding our flag in Delhi also, Srimati Aruna Sairam ji, Secretary of Parthasarathy Swami Sabha, Mr. Krishnamurthy. Today is 1st November, and the 1st November is also very apt for all of us, and our Excellency is a very distinguished cultural ambassador of India, and it is his first cultural function in the cultural capital of India. Already, I think we have been told that he hails from a very noble family which has contributed to cultural and literary causes, and he is also one of the guiding forces of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. And it is therefore apt that he is also now participating in this function, which is also of all India character, Bharatiya Sangeet Utsav. And in fact, each year this function has been undergoing different shapes and varieties due to the innovative thinking of Mr. Sashikiran and his team. And we are, in fact, very fortunate to have all the distinguished dignitaries on the stage. I am only to render a vote of thanks. Therefore, I profusely thank once again His Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, for having taken his valuable time to be present. And we hope and I am sure that he will be part of several other cultural functions in the city. We thank our President, Dr. Nalli Kuppuswami Chettiyar, Srimati Aruna Sairam for the wonderful invocation song, Srimati Sudha Raja, the force behind organizing the children from the Sangam choir, and also training all other young students, making the inauguration very, very colorful, at the same time, very patriotic as well. At the same time, we should also not forget our sponsors, supporters, individual donors who have made this function quite successful this year as well, including Lancor. And we also thank the press photographs, photographers and all others, the technicians and the staff of Narada Sabha and other persons who have done stage work. And more importantly, the Rasikas who have come in large numbers in spite of the unusually inclement weather in the city of Chennai. Thank you.
I'd request you all to stand for the national anthem. It will be led by Vidushi Aruna Sairam.
அவன் சொன்னா